Hey guys, Gifteen here, and welcome back to some more Let's Play DanganRonpa 2. In the last episode, after we came to our abrupt end, a lot of shit went down, isn't that right, Parav?
Yeah.
Let's see, Nekomaru almost died, Ibuki broke our lock, we got Chiaki's panties.
Aha!
Not everything was bad, but...
And we gave her a kiss note, remember?
Oh yeah, we did give her that kiss note. Oh, good. Anyway, let's move on with this. Hey, you understand too, right? When the stupid ones try to act on their own, it makes trouble for everyone else.
Hey!
So can you please not involve me? I don't want to die a meaningless death.
That is...
Hyoko, blaming Akane will not help solve anything. We don't have to worry about Coach Nekomaru.
Huh?
Huh? Man, that's disappointing. It's all your fault and you're not even worried about him. Akane, you're not worried about Nekomaru?
Damn it!
There's no need to be worrying. I know Coach Nekomaru is a monstrous guy. There's no way he's gonna die from something like that. There's no doubt, Nekomaru is definitely gonna come back.
Damn it.
So, when that happens, I'll make sure I apologize to him. Because I was too weak, and I caused him trouble. So when he comes back, I'll make sure to say I'm sorry. Akane. Aww.
GG. Yo!
Yeah?
Is it supposed to be a black screen right now?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
See the text on the bottom?
No.
No?
I don't see any text anywhere.
Really?
Yeah, it's just a black...
You don't even see the capture window anymore?
No, I see the capture window, but I don't see any text.
Really? You don't see, blue text anywhere?
What, on the... No, I don't see blue text now. No.
Really?
No.
Why don't you move the scene ahead to see if it changes for you? Yeah. Since we all returned to our cottages, we were silent. Even if we opened our mouths...
Wait, you're reading now?
Yes, I'm reading now.
No, there's nothing on the screen.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, let me see what happens when I... go to the next scene. Maybe something will happen. Even if we opened our mouths, only words of worry would come out. We all knew that. When we saw Nekomaru's tragedy happen right in front of us, once again, we were all taught, if you think you won't die, well, that's just wishful thinking. On this island, without any warning, people die. That is the nightmare we're all trapped in. And when you think you've finally woken up from the nightmare, you realize you're still inside it. And thus, the nightmare continues. Can you see that?
Oops, still a black screen.
Alright, hold on. Something weird's going on, because I can't even hear anything on my TV, so let me try restarting the recording real quick. Okay, we are back. Sorry for that little delay. Can you see now?
Yep.
Okay, good. So now let's move on to the moment everyone's been waiting for, of course, Monokuma Theater.
Aha!
Monokuma's super fabulous story 58. A Tengu came down from the mountains. A long time ago, there was a village that was afraid of Tengu showing up. Tengus apparently did his duties, such as stealing food and kidnapping women.
What the?
But is it really the Tengu's fault? Actually,
yeah.
The human's fault for ruining nature by destroying the mountains where the Tengus lived? You think monsters are scary? It's humans that are the scary ones. Everyone, now is the time to rise up against the humans. We must protect nature from the humans and return the world to a peaceful place where monsters roam free.
Bring it on!
Monokuma's super fables. The end.
Wow, what an abrupt ending.
It's pretty deep. Anyway, I believe now we're going to be presented with our motive.
Ahem! Good.
As usual, well, even if I say that, it doesn't matter anymore. But I greeted the morning without having slept at all. I really wanted to see somebody, anybody, as fast as I could. I felt like I had to share this anxious feeling with someone. I just couldn't deal with it alone. I should go to the restaurant for now. Let's make our way over.
Oh!
As I was walking to the restaurant, unintentionally, I felt my feet come to a swift halt. Someone's crying.
Oh no.
From inside the restaurant, I heard the sound of a girl crying. Is someone crying inside? Miko? Or is it Hyoko? While peeking into the restaurant, I slowly stepped inside. Oh boy.
Oh.
Akane? You're the one who's crying? I'm scared. What's gonna happen to me? I'm scared. What happened? Could she be in shock about what happened to Nakamaru? But yesterday she was acting braver. Oh, son of a bitch.
There we go.
Bum USB socket. Anyway, let's see what's going on. Who do you think we should ask? Oh, hold on. Whoops. Alright, who do you think we should ask for information? Hyoko or Nagito?
Hyoko.
Hyoko? Alright.
Hey!
It's definitely best if we keep Nagito tied up. No, not just tied up.
So...
until I peel the skin off his face and expose the meat so he can't identify him anymore.
Oh my god, she's a violent
one. That doesn't sound very gentle. Did he do something to you? That idiot. He lied to me about my hero being alive and said he saw her at the movie theater. What? Why is he telling such a pointless lie? I don't know. I hate being lied to.
Jeez!
I won't feel satisfied until all his joints are bent at awkward angles. It'd probably be a waste of time to find out the reason for each little thing Nagito does, but I don't get this at all. Why do you have to tell us such an outrageous lie? Oh, now we gotta talk to Nagito.
Yeah.
Looks pretty mad. Hey, what happened to Akane? Isn't she acting kind of weird?
I see!
Hajime, be careful! That's probably not the real Fuyuhiko! Huh?
What?
I know. The real Fuyuhiko is already dead. That's why that's probably Fuyuhiko's clone.
What the hell are you talking about, bro?
What are you saying?
Hey!
Also, I heard from Mononokuma that Nakamaru couldn't be saved. It's unfortunate, but a transfer student is apparently going to come soon as a replacement.
So oh,
let's all give
what?
That person a warm welcome. Are you messing around?
It's the truth!
I'm not messing around, I always speak the truth.
Right?
In order to prove it, I'll explain it specially to you.
Listen carefully.
Listen carefully, Hajime. I finally discovered who the traitor is. You know the true identity of Worldender? The traitor who's hiding among us is...
There's no mistake.
Byakuya.
What?
That's right, Byakuya is alive.
No way.
He's been weird from the start, but... isn't he acting much weirder than usual? Oh boy. What happened, Akane? It's not like you to cry. Get a grip on yourself. I don't know what to do anymore. I mean, Nakamaru got killed, you know? What are you saying? It's not like Nakamaru's dead yet. I'm scared. I don't want this anymore. There's no way that explains a change this sudden and drastic.
Yes!
Pardon me, everyone, but you have some... but you happen to have some time to spare.
Hello! My name is Ibuki Miyota.
Hi, Ibuki. It may be rude of me, but I would like to say my greetings
Ibuki.
First thing in the morning. Good morning. I look forward to working with you all today. Ibuki? Yes, I am Ibuki Miyota. Aren't you acting strange, too?
Wait!
Be careful, Ibuki. Hajime is dangerous. He wants to kill you and eat you. Nagito.
What? Is wrong with Nagito?
I don't know. What are you saying?
Yes.
One of the traits.
Mr. Hajime, I am not tasty. Please do not eat me. He's obviously lying. I see. So it was a lie.
It's the truth.
It's not a lie. I never tell lies.
Understood.
I see. So it is not a lie. It may be necessary for me to beg for my life after all. What the heck is this? Akane, Nagito so Ibuki, they're acting so strange. What's going on? Did they go crazy or something? It wouldn't be strange to go crazy in a situation like this.
You've got it wrong!
That's not it.
Yes!
Ibuki, she has an extremely high fever. That's probably the cause.
That's weird!
Before you start talking, I want you to tell me something. Who the hell are you?
What?
Yoga.
Why
have you forgotten me? I'm Mikan Samiki. Anyway, please try touching her forehead. If you do, you'll see what I mean. My hand to her forehead. Ibuki, just a second.
Understood.
In exchange, please spare my life. I softly placed my hand onto Ibuki's forehead while she continued to spout gibberish. She's hot. What is this? This heat is abnormal.
Yes!
That's right. She has a terribly high fever. Akane, let me feel your forehead too. I'm sorry, I'm so weak. I placed my hand on the Akane's forehead while she groaned and kept sobbing. That must be it. She has such a high fever, there's no way that's normal. That's a normal human body temperature. Nagito, you too. I don't have a fever. I feel extremely great today. I placed my hand on his forehead. Once again, I got the same result.
What?
All three of them have fevers? The reason those guys are saying such wacky stuff is...
Emergency! Emergency!
My goodness, that's obviously bad. Oh, Monokuma. Monokuma.
This guy.
For him to appear right now. Does that mean this is...
Just a minute!
Whoa there, can you just wait a second for the explanation? The others are on their way too. And just as Monokuma said, I heard the sound of pounding footsteps. Everyone who gathered all had confused expressions plastered on their faces.
What's going on?
Now what?
Hey!
Looks like something strange is going on again.
Now then!
Looks like everyone's here. Now then, let's start with the explanation.
Wait!
Hold on! Monokuma, you're pulling a prank again, aren't you? I want to have a Nekomaru. Hurry up and return him first, you robber bear. Nekomaru? Are you talking about the boy who turns into a woman when he gets splashed with water? What the fuck?
You stupid brother!
Who the heck is that? Nekomaru doesn't have a weird ability like that.
Jeez! Shut up!
Finally a sane panda. What the heck?
Can you make any sense of
Monokuma,
this?
Monokuma, you little... No, it's just brother and sister are fighting. Clearly, when the sister is sane.
Yeah.
I don't even know what's been done to me, but I feel a mysterious, like, energy.
Oh, Monokuma.
Well, man.
Now that I've shut up the nuisance.
Hey, Monokuma.
Let's go back to the topic at hand.
Well, done.
You guys have already noticed since you're all so quick-witted. So, it's just as I thought. I tried to know what this high fever is.
That's right!
That's right. This is the new motive that I've given you.
It's the despair disease!
It's the despair disease.
Okay.
This is by far the weirdest motive so far.
Yeah.
What the?
Despair disease.
Actually...
You know, there are extremely tiny insects that can't be seen with the naked eye living on this island.
It's true!
It's not like I added them recently. I just never told you about them. Anyway, the endemic disease spread by these insects is called the despair disease. Despair disease? I've never heard of such a thing.
Well?
Let me tell you about it. As the name suggests, despair disease is a really annoying disease where you get a high fever along with various symptoms that are full of despair. The symptoms are different based on that person. For instance, Nagito is afflicted by the liar disease. Kane has the coward disease. Ibuki has the gullible disease, I guess?
What?
That's pretty interesting.
It is. They just had to get symptoms that are the opposite of their normal personalities. Except for Nagito.
Hey!
It's not like all you guys are down with the sickness yet. But be careful, sometimes the despair disease can get passed on from person to person just like a cold.
Huh?
You mean it's contagious? Don't put your guard down just because you don't have the seeds. It'd be awful if everyone got sick.
Hey!
What's wrong, Miss Sonia? It'd be terrible if you caught the lowly disease of the common folks. Shut the hell up, Kazuichi. That's right, let's run away. I don't want to catch such a weird disease.
Why?
Why is that a motive? Are you saying that a triangular person falls into a crazy state?
Phew!
Isn't this quite a novel idea?
I can't wait! I can't wait!
A killing that occurs while everyone has a completely different personality. Think of all the murder tricks.
What the heck is this kind of thing?
Is there any way to treat it?
Like...
Why? Is there a need to treat it? I mean, this despair disease isn't supposed to make you suffer. It's a disease that cures your soft hearts. Your soft hearts towards killing. And with this, you can finally take the plunge and commit murder!
Oh my god.
You bastard, you better stop talking about this bullshit! It's all my fault. I'm sorry I'm always bothering you.
Alright!
I decided, as an apology, I'm going to commit murder. Are there any charcoal briquettes somewhere?
What?
Shut the fuck up, Nagito.
What the heck?
I'm pretty sure I found some in the supermarket. Mikan, you're not helping.
Oh my god, Mikan, stop.
Stop it. Mikan, Nagito, Ibuki, you guys stay put.
Hey.
You're wrong. I'm not Nagito.
Oh my god, here we go.
Nagito Kamiya is a fake name. I'm sorry I've kept that a secret until now.
Understood.
Oh, I see.
What the?
She's believing him again. So serious.
Amazing.
Man, whatever I feel, whatever. I feel so great today. This despair disease is awesome. despair. It's amazing.
Shit.
You all should get it too. We're all done for.
No.
There's no such thing as hope. We all have to die from this despair disease. That's... oh my way.
What is he now fighting?
Whoa!
Oh, he fainted.
Nagito? Now that I've given you a new motive, how will things develop? Will the killing start after everyone gets the spare disease? Or even before that?
Thrills! Chills! Kills!
I'm so excited about it, I'm just gonna stand around naked.
Bring it on!
Just kidding. I'm always naked. God damn it, hey! Damn it, Nekomaru's incident just happened, and now this? Where did that peaceful mood that lasted till yesterday go? This is bad. Nagito is foaming at the mouth.
Whoa.
She's right. I've never even seen foam that color before.
Impossible!
Oh,
that's an ephemerally... I don't even know how to fucking say that word.
Ephemerally
rare color. Normally only found in the depths of the Netherworld Sea. In this case, the color doesn't matter, so let's hurry him over to the hospital.
What was he, poisoned?
Huh?
Is the foam because of the sickness?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Got it, I'll help out.
Please wait!
What should we do about Akane and Ibuki?
Anyway.
We're definitely going to bring them too. We don't know what they'll do if we leave them alone. Hey bastard, can you walk?
Yes.
Allow me to confirm. I just have to alternate the movements of my left and right leg, correct?
Oh my god.
Hold on. I'll walk, so don't leave me. Then let's go. With the diseased in tow and Nagito, whose condition was clearly worsening, we rushed over to the hospital. But this kind of motive is impossible. An actual despair disease? There's a possibility that might be passed along. What the heck? Damn it, what should I do? Oh, man. I will go and make the infected change their clothes, and then I'll have them sleep in the patient rooms.
Understood.
So I just have to change my clothes, correct? Scared of changing. Anyway, everyone else, please wait here. As she supported all three of them with her shoulders, Mikan disappeared into the depths of the hospital.
Damn it,
I never expected us to get sick. What's going to happen?
Let me tell you this.
I would not mind if Nagito retired. Permanently. I agree with Gundam on that one.
Maybe...
personally change their clothes? What's wrong with that?
Well...
Does that include Nagito too? Isn't that a little bad? There's no need to panic. Even I attend to the remains of my four dark demons of destruction.
Oh, hey,
don't lump hamsters and teenage boys together. Hey, is this stupid conversation going to last much longer?
Hey!
Shouldn't we seriously be thinking about what we need to do from now on and stuff? What we need to do from now on? Since she brought it up, let's see what she has to say.
Yeah.
Jeez!
That disease sure looks dangerous. Nagito, Akane, and Ibuki aren't acting normal. If it spreads to anyone else, a killing is bound to happen.
Let me tell you this.
Based on their observed behavior, I cannot deny that.
But
those guys aren't being considerate. I want them to at least have the decency to consider committing suicide before they start bothering us. What the fuck?
That's fucked up.
That is...
Hey, Hyoko. I know, it can't be that easy. So it's important to make sure we don't end up catching the disease. Sure. What do you mean?
Which cockroach said that?
Jeez, why don't you get it? We need to isolate them from us so they won't spread the disease. Isolate?
You!
If you can't cure it, the only option is to stop it from spreading. Even a preschooler knows that. But still, isn't isolating them a bit too harsh?
Yeah.
Hey, if everyone catches the despair disease, we won't be able to do anything about it anymore, you know?
This is bad!
You're right. There's no way we should allow it to spread. Hold on a sec.
Find a cure.
There is no cure. Monokuma just said so. There is no way.
Oh yeah, he did. Oh, that's screwed up.
What wouldn't be much of a motive if you could cure it, would it?
Yeah, that's true.
It's not like any of them are like scientists or anything that could find the cure.
That's true too.
Hey, hey!
Isolation. You mean we need to quarantine them inside the hospital, right? Chiaki, don't tell me you also agree with this.
That's wrong.
It's to prevent a killing. As long as that disease is Monokuma's motive, if we just ignore it, a killing will happen again. To prevent that, we also have to prevent the disease from spreading. That's why we need to quarantine them.
Like...
Where are they gonna quarantine them?
In the hospital.
In the hospital?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Even if we quarantine them, who's gonna take care of them? Mikan's gonna stay here anyway. She's been touching the infected all over, so it's possible she's already caught the disease. But there's no way we can leave her by herself.
Hey!
Then why don't you stay too? Huh?
Huh?
Now that I think about it, you touched them when you took their temperature, right? Oh.
Wow.
Good job, Hajime. So, I'll leave
her to you.
Contact me if something happens. Contact you? How are we supposed to do that?
Jeez!
Alright, we need to think of a way to communicate. If we keep meeting in person, we can catch the disease.
Hey, you!
So, I'll let you handle that, Kazuichi. Yeah, got it.
Fine.
When Shintoina see the cheetah boss.
Uh-huh. Best not to question her. Fret not. We are not going to abandon you. I shall station myself nearby in case anything happens. Nearby. There is a motel on this island. Until this matter is resolved, we shall stay the night there.
Aww.
What? Do we really have to stay in such a dirty place?
Silence.
What are we supposed to do if we can't immediately get here if something happens? Also, if that disease is airborne, the hotel on the first island might already be unsafe.
This is the Tanaka Empire!
We must be vigilant about protection. I have those who I must protect. They're just hamsters, dude.
I'll destroy you!
That is an unkind thing to say, you fiend. How dare you call my four dark demons of destruction hamsters?
Jeez!
Fine, I'll stay at the motel, okay? Jeez, how annoying. Even if it's quarantine, we're still gonna be on the same island, so just call us if something happens.
Huh?
What? What are you frustrated for?
I don't like this.
This is obviously a trap. Monokuma's goal is to separate us as a group. Is it really okay for us to fall for that?
So...
It's not like we've stopped being friends. I just don't want a killing to happen ever again. We can't prevent that if everyone gets sick, you know?
You know, right?
Yeah, that's right, man. There's no way we're gonna lose together here, you know?
That's right!
Because if that happens, then Monokuma gets what he wants. Hey, Hyoko, what'd you say to me earlier? Something about me being the first one to get cut off?
And?
What's wrong with that?
Huh.
This must be that moment. It's not like Mikan and Hajime are enough people.
You!
Are you saying you're gonna stay here too? Huh? You too. This life of mine is a spare anyway.
Huh.
Fine then, do whatever you want. Hey, Fuhiko, are you sure? You might be endangering yourself, you know.
Jeez.
Hey, don't make me repeat myself.
Hey, hey!
You're really, really okay with this then. Then I'm gonna leave the rest to you, too. Whatever's happening over here, leave it to us. We'll make sure we'll make sure to keep the disease from spreading. Come on.
Alright, Yuhiko.
Yeah, his character's really changing, and I like that.
Yeah, me too. Yeah.
Come on, shouldn't you guys head over to the motel before you catch the disease?
I am sorry!
I'm sorry we're forcing this upon you like this. No, what everyone's saying is true, so it's okay.
Thanks.
Thank you, both of you. I won't let your feelings go to waste. We'll make sure to find out the mystery of the despair disease while you're all here.
I think.
Probably. Thanks for the certainty, Chiaki. I'd really prefer it if she had a more confident-sounding catchphrase.
Yeah. I agree with Hinata on this one.
Now then, I shall excuse myself. I am counting on you. Then I'll make sure to figure some way to communicate later.
Bye!
Bye-bye. Do your best to try and stay alive. And just like that, the others left, leaving me and Fuyuhiko at the hospital. Never expected it would turn out like this.
Jeez!
It's not like it's their fault. It's that bastard Monokuma's fault. I can't believe he'd actually arrange something as irritating as a disease.
Hello!
Thank you for waiting. They finally finished changing. Everyone's resting in their rooms. Huh? Why is it just you two?
Huh?
You know. I know. They must have left to get fruits to bring back later. Everyone's so kind. I'm so glad everyone is so thoughtful toward their friends.
Well,
like I said, we're all equals when we get sick. Let's all work together and do our very best.
She's so...
I'm sorry, but I'll let you handle the explanation. That's quite the burden I have to bear. And so we decided to split into two groups. In the hospital, there were the three people who caught the Monokuma's despair disease, Akane, Nagato, and Ibuki. There's also Mikan, who's nursing them back to health. And as a safeguard, Fuyuhiko and myself. Altogether, six people are staying at the hospital. Chiaki, Gundam, Kazuichi, Sonya, and Hyoko are staying at the motel on the same island. As for Nakamaru, he's not back yet, but... Anyway, until we do something about this despair disease, our current situation isn't going to change. But we have no clue what we need to do. Seriously, what should we do?
I wonder...
I suddenly woke up. And if I woke up, that means I fell asleep without realizing it. Earlier, I discussed it with Fuyuhiko and we decided we'd take turns resting. That's right. That's why I came to the on-call room on the second floor of the hospital. I haven't been sleeping well for the past few days, so a sudden drowsiness overtook me. And I was asleep, which is a good thing, but... my body feels really heavy for some reason. No, it's not just heavy. It feels somewhat soft, and... oh boy. I know what's happening right now.
I have no idea.
Well, you'll see in a couple seconds.
Oh my god.
Damn.
That is... oh my... I'm done. I quit. Screw you, Hinata.
He's too good.
Mikan!
No, dude, take a look at his hair, too.
Yeah, why is it pointy?
I don't know. It's funny, though.
I'm so confused on so many levels.
You're tickling me.
What?
I can't breathe!
Cyanotic reaction.
Hajime, no kidding.
Get a hold of yourself. Mikan finally got off me, grabbed my shoulders, and began shaking me intensely. Somehow that was enough to get my consciousness to drift back to reality.
Hajime!
Hajime, you've regained consciousness. I'm so glad. I thought you died. Me too. I seriously thought I was gonna die.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I thought about taking a rest in the on-call room, but you were already asleep, so... That doesn't mean you can climb on top of me. Then I'll be on the bottom next time.
Wow.
This chick. That's seriously not what I'm talking about.
Hey, hey.
Hey. What are you guys doing? You Hiko? No, this is... I really hope you don't get the wrong idea.
Don't tell me!
Were you guys sleeping together?
Bastard!
You dirty, rotten bastard! You guys are fucking high school students! Seriously, you got this all wrong.
Damn it!
We don't have time for that. Nagito, he's in danger. Danger? What?
What?
When I peeked inside his room earlier, it looked like he wasn't breathing.
Oh no.
Huh? Huh? This is bad. Now's not the time for us to rest. Mikan vigorously leapt out of bed and ran out of the on-call room.
Damn it!
Hajime, now's not the time for you to be pitching a tent. We need to hurry.
Nice, Fuyuhiko. That is pretty awesome.
Seriously, I'm not... Fuyuhiko and I chased after Mikan and ran into Nagito's room.
Well, let's see what's up.
He's in pretty bad shape. Nagito, please get a hold of yourself. Despite Mikan's desperate pleas, I didn't see Nagito react at all.
Don't tell me!
There's no way he died, right? The body discovery announcement is the plan, right?
Hey, fidget! Fidget!
What the hell is he doing here?
I don't know, but he's gone now. Damn it, he's totally waiting for it.
Damn it!
This looks very bad. Let's look at Nagito.
Yeah.
Despite Mikan's desperate cries, I didn't see Nagito react at all. Maybe not. Mikan, is Nagito alright?
Well...
It looks like his breathing has returned. Really? But still, his condition is unpredictable, and that's putting it lightly.
Hey!
How light is that? Is it sweet potato soft?
Well...
If so, that's pretty light. Please don't interfere.
Hey.
Hey, look. Isn't Nagito's mouth moving? You're right. He might be trying to say something. Nagito, what happened? As she said his name, Mikan slowly tilted her ear toward Nagito's lips. What did he say? Apparently his condition has improved, and he feels quite refreshed. Since Monokuma said that Nagito has the liar disease, he probably means the opposite. And naturally feels really crappy.
Like...
But what's going to happen if he just dies? We're not going to have a class trial, right? Don't talk like that.
Yes!
Nagito is never going to die. I will save him by any means necessary.
I see.
Got it. Then I leave Nagito's life to you.
Yes!
Far from her usual self, Mikan responded assertively and went back to tending Nagito. If we stay here any longer, we might just get in the way.
Damn right!
Then follow me. While you were resting, the goods arrived. I gotta show them to you. The goods aren't something dangerous, right?
Anyway.
Let's go to the lobby. Alright.
Let's check it out.
Damn right!
Look on top of the reception desk. On top of the reception desk. Well, Figo's talking about this, right?
See?
Looks like a monitor and a camera. Hey, what is this?
Huh.
Perfect timing. Blue light is blinking. Does something happen when this blinks? Seeing is believing, as they say. Try pressing the button just below that light.
What's up?
Hey, is this Hajime?
Oh, this guy.
Loud and clear. Looks like it's perfectly connected. Kazuichi? Then this is... Yeah, that's right. That's the way to communicate he was talking about.
Alright!
Looks like it's time for the ultimate mechanic to shine. How about it? This is what I've been working on. Remember that alley with all those shady looking street booths? That's where I found this. It's a surveillance camera for household use. I just tweaked it a little. So now it's basically a video chat device. Well, it's pretty hit or miss. Video chat, huh?
I get it.
It's true, we don't have to worry about getting infected with this.
That's right!
So, it may be a hassle, but we'll be contacting each other with this from now on, okay? This is only a test run this time, so I guess this should be pretty fun. Okay then, see you later. Kazuichi left this while you're resting.
Damn right!
The surveillance camera unit comes with a surveillance camera and monitor. Anything the camera records is broadcast live on the monitor. So we prepared two of these sets and swapped each of their cameras. I see, by swapping the cameras, his monitor will display what's on my camera, and vice versa. Apparently he also modified it a little. He widened its narrow communication range beyond just household use.
Even so,
he still had a limit, so apparently the signal can't reach from the hospital to the motel. Then we can't communicate between the hospital and the motel. You didn't notice? He was contacting you just now from the music venue near the motel. There, the signal reaches the hospital with no problems. But they're staying at the motel, right? What happens if we can't reach them when we need to?
Damn right!
I thought the same thing. So we rearranged times for us to contact each other. Instead of for us to communicate 30 minutes after the morning, this morning and evening announcements. Our next contact with them is going to be tomorrow morning. Don't sleep in. He's well prepared. As expected of the heir of an enormous organization.
Huh?
What is it? Nothing. And there's the nighttime announcement.
What? Okay.
It is now 10 p.m.
All
right. Please return to your rooms and read Melbourne.
Oh, shit. This is probably what's going to go down, right?
I think it is.
Shit.
So that time already, huh? Now then, where should I sleep tonight? Am I planning to use the on-call room with a certain someone again? Like I said, it's not what it looked like.
You guys?
Hey, aren't you misunderstanding?
What are you thinking?
A hospital is a facility for sick people, so it's not for lodging and young romantic trysts, you know? You two? What are you talking about?
I don't like this!
Oh, I see. Your generation has fallen out of the habit of looking at bulletin boards.
I'm being horrible.
Come on, take a look at the bulletin board. There's a notice on there, right? Forbidden.
In other words...
Right. It's like the notices you often see inside hospitals. You can't stay overnight here.
What are you saying?
There is one patient who needs to be accompanied. You're talking about Nagito, right?
Unbelievable.
No, there's one patient. The rest of you need to hurry up and get out of here.
Jeez.
Hospital precautions, my ass. He should have said so sooner. Only one person can stay the night. There's no way we can make Mikan leave.
Jeez,
you're
pathetic.
We have no choice. We should head back to our cottages then. You're right. Even if we stay here, we probably won't be able to do anything. After explaining the circumstances to Mikan, we decided to head back to our cottages for the time being. Oh, man.
Shit, man. Now those two are by themselves.
What do you mean those two? Those four? Mikan and... Yeah. Oh, wait, what do you mean those two? Hajime and Fuhiko?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I was confused by what you're talking about. Anyway. So Fuhiko and I are going to be the only ones sleeping in our cottages tonight. I'm a little worried. No, the ones who are stuck in the hospital should be more worried.
Yeah, that's true.
What's the point of me getting so worried? Alright. Wake up tomorrow, I'll go to the hospital right away. I feel bad leaving Mikan alone. I guess for now I should try getting some sleep. Monokuma Theater.
Monokuma appears!
Good evening, it's time for Monokuma's cooking class.
What cares about your cooking class?
Today we're gonna learn how to make taiyaki. The first thing you'll need is a time machine. Travel back in time to the Meiji period and meet a person named Seijiro Kanbei. He used to bake and sell turtle-shaped pieces, but it's Marco happily makes his pastries in the shape of a fish. As a final touch, name these pastries Taiyaki. Okay, with this, you finished making Taiyaki.
Brought to you by Monokuma!
This concludes Monokuma's cooking class.
Wow, oh my god, what a waste of, like, this guy.
That's what that's a waste of a fucking time machine right there.
Yeah. Oh, no. Oh, it's morning?
Ahem. Yeah, morning announcement.
Hope speak good. Now then.
Someone died.
No one's dead yet. Or at least three people haven't found a body yet. Because that's when the body discovery announcement goes off. When three or more people find a body for the first time.
Oh, okay.
I'm worried about Mikan and the others. I should hurry over to the hospital. The moment I got out of bed, I immediately left my cottage and headed over to the hospital. I think it's tomorrow everything goes down. I believe that's what happens.
Yo,
you came early today. You're the one who's early.
Damn right!
Well, I just got here. So what should we do? There's still a little time before we need to make contact. Want to go to Nagito's room and check up on him? Yeah, I'm worried about how he's doing. Worry? Why do I have to worry about a guy like him? Still.
Yep.
Mikan, how's Nagito doing? Same as usual. No, actually, he might be worse than yesterday.
This is bad!
Are you fucking serious? His pulse is extremely weak. He might slip into critical condition sometime today.
Whoa.
Is he that sick? But as long as I'm his nurse, I will never let Nagito die.
Yes!
Ever. I do understand how you feel, but don't overexert yourself, okay? Hey, Hajime. It's almost time to start the connection. We need to head over to the lobby. Yeah, got it. After being reminded of how powerless I am, I left Nagito's room. Boy, things are not looking good.
Yeah. Yo, I want to know what goes on.
I know.
Tonight, yeah.
The incoming signal light is blinking.
Now then.
Looks like they're already waiting. Let's hurry up and start the connection. Yeah, you're right. Press the button underneath the monitor and... I pressed the button underneath the blinking light and the monitor instantly lit up. Looks like the camera and monitor had no problem making a connection. Soon enough, a familiar face showed up on the other side of the monitor. Hey, Kazuichi.
What's up?
Hello, how is it? Can you see my handsome face? Yeah, I can see you real clear. We're good on our end, too. I can totally see your broke-ass faces. Wow, Kazuichi.
Wow.
It might be best if I tell the others about Nagito's condition. Hey, are you the only one over there?
Nope.
We're all here except for Hyoko. What happened to...
Where's Hyoko?
It seems we all look like aberrant enemies in the eyes of that coward. But she has locked herself in her room. She said from the other side of the door that she won't come out until the despair disease has been cured. Even being cautious around the others in the motel, huh? Looks like they're also in a testy situation.
Hey.
So how about you? How are you guys doing? Yeah, about that. Tell you the truth, Nagi is actually in serious danger. I already know he's seriously dangerous.
Well.
No, not that. He's seriously wandering the border between life and death.
What?
What did you say?
However...
But he's going to be okay, right? Nagito is going to get better.
Hey!
First Nagamaru, then Nagito? That ain't funny at all. Well, for now, can't really say. What the hell is that typo?
We really... Yeah... Where's the...
Damn it.
Apostrophe?
You really can't say. That's impossible. At least Monami corrected it.
Yeah, thank you.
Monami, why are you on that side?
Because
it'd be dangerous if I got too close to the hospital, since I don't even know what's going on there. You are really pissing me off. Why does a stupid stuffed animal need to be cautious about a disease?
You can't!
Please don't discriminate. That despair disease is horrible. It's a dangerous disease that can even destroy this island. So, until we figure out how to deal with it, I will be on this side. It's fucking helpful.
Monami's too good.
Before I could even respond to Monami, Fuyuhiko had cut the connection.
Don't fuck with me!
Shitty stuffed animal. She seriously pissed me off.
What the hell?
Damn it, I'm going outside to cool off. Fuyuhiko practically spat those words before he went outside. Anyway, all we can do now is wait. Just wait patiently until the situation improves and changes for the better. That's why we waited patiently. Because waiting patiently was the only thing we could do. We waited patiently. On a side note, why can't I relax when I'm in a hospital? I paced back and forth around the hospital lobby. Fuyuhiko entered and left the hospital many times. And time just kept passing by. Should have borrowed some of Chiaki's video games.
Yep, nighttime.
Yep, nighttime.
Ahem! It is please now
the time, yeah.
Damn it!
Feels like a lot of stuff got skipped over and now it's nighttime already. It's almost time for tonight's transmission.
Jeez.
We should go back to our cottage when that's done. It's fucking annoying to keep going back and forth though. But before we go back, can we check on Nakato one more time? Go for it. Leave the transmission thing to me.
Jeez!
They're not gonna have a new clue anyway. I can handle this. Then I'll leave it to you. Nagito. Oh hey, Ibuki.
Oh my god, that's creepy. That is so creepy.
Whoa, Ibuki! What are you doing here? You need to be rested.
Yes!
To tell you the truth, I have been getting quite bored doing nothing but sleeping. Also, it would just trouble you if I slept all the time, so I was hoping I could help you with anything. But it's better if I'm sleeping, correct? Yeah, just get some rest for now. It'd be a big help if you got better soon.
Understood.
Yes, understood. That's kind of scary. I hope she gets better real soon. God damn. This hospital is crazy as hell anyway.
Yeah.
Mikan's too focused on caring for Nagito. She hasn't even noticed that I entered the room. Has she been caring for him this whole time? Hey, Mikan. Hey, Mikan. No matter how many times I talk to her, she's not responding. Her back is turned toward me as she's focused on caring for Nagato. I peeked over Mikan's shoulder and said, "Hey, Mikan, are you okay?" And scared the shit out of her. Looks like you finally noticed. Yeah, please don't surprise me like that. I almost got wet.
What the heck?
Did you come by to check on Nagito? I just wanted to see how he's doing. But you look pretty tired, too. Isn't it better if you get a little rest? I hope I'm not mistaken. That'd be really embarrassing. Are you, by chance, worried about me? Yeah, pretty much. Thank you very much. I'll remember this moment until the day I die. I'm starting to get my energy back, so I'll get back to taking care of Nagito. I hope she understood what I said. She's working so hard, it'd be bad if I kept getting in her way. That's exactly how I felt, so I decided just to shut up and go back to the lobby.
Yo!
Yo, how's Nagito doing? I'm more worried about Mikan than Nagito. She looks like she's had no time to rest.
Damn it.
Nagito's probably not doing so well. What about you? Are you guys done with the transmission?
Jeez.
As I expected, we wrapped it up quickly, like they had nothing new to report. They're apparently trying to find a cure somehow, but there hasn't been any progress. So on both our ends, looks like we had no results.
Jeez,
oh well.
You're pathetic.
Look forward to it tomorrow. With a depressingly heavy mood riding on our backs, we headed back to our cottages. So dude, tomorrow's the day.
Oh my god, here we go!
My worries have piled so high that one side just isn't enough. And the more I think about it, it's like I'm slowly being sucked deeper and deeper into an endless pit. I guess for today, I should just go to sleep. It's best if I not dwell on it too much. And not just that, the first thing in the morning I need to do is go to the hospital again.
And you'll find something interesting.
I kept telling myself that as I sighed one last time, and slowly closed my eyes.
Ding dong, bing bong.
Not yet. Out of the blue, a hazy scene began to take shape.
What?
From the depths of my consciousness, it slowly took its time. Hazily. Like watercolor paints suspended in water. Slowly. Hazily. There was a classroom from somewhere. A classroom that I've seen before. But I don't know where. I can hear voices. Somebody's talking. Did you hear that? Isn't it amazing? Apparently he's been accepted into Hope's Peak Academy. But he was that exceptional? Those are noises. I'm dully staring out the window, pretending not to listen. I don't want to listen. But even if I don't want to listen, the noises leap into my ears. Huh? You don't know? Eh? Know what? Apparently, you don't have to be exceptional to get into Hope's Peak Academy. But it's an academy that recruits only exceptional students from around the world, right? I wanted to cover my ears. I wanted to run. To the place I deserve to be. Not here. To the place where I can be more confident. Wow, I never knew that way was possible. So he's the same too? Obviously. I mean, he doesn't have any special talents and that Hope's Peak Academy would be interested. He's just a normal guy that can be found anywhere. Well, admiring the Academy is free, but it must be tough for the parents who have to write the check. Leave me alone. I just want to become someone who's confident in myself. What is this, anyway? Who are they talking about? Why can't I remember? Who am I? Oh, I thought this wouldn't happen.
Oh my god.
Hey! Hey!
Not this talking.
Let's find out. Did you know that talking about a personal failure is a good way to break the ice with people? That's not the thing I'd open up on.
Yeah, not me either.
So I'm gonna tell you a story of my personal failure. In the world I live in, popularity is a symbol of power. That's why I decided to write a fake love letter for myself, so I could brag about it to others.
What the hell?
I was bragging about it to my friend, and unfortunately all I had was an envelope. My friend wanted me to show him the unwritten letter, but I was in a real bind. So I showed him a blank piece of paper and said this. This letter was written in with special ink. Only those chosen by God can see it.
Okay, that's mad weird.
When I said that, he was all, that love letter is brimming with passion. However, things started to look bad at that point. Other people around us started praising him because they thought he could really see and read the letter. That's when he started talking about the divine messenger of God. Eventually, he was worshipped by society.
Huh.
Now, he still uses his followers to sell shady vases for his butt. My big mouth became a multi-millionaire. How regretful, what an epic fail. That was my story of personal proof. What'd you think? The ice broke? Wanna buy this vase? It's a pretty high demand. They'll give you a deal because I like you so much. Oh man. It's morning, huh? But for some
here
reason.
We go.
My body's heavy. No, not just heavy. It's somewhat soft and really hot.
No.
Wait a minute.
No. Not this again. Oh my god.
Look at his fucking face.
Oh my lord, not again. His hair too, like.
It's all broken now.
This guy.
Not again? Hurry up and move! I can't breathe!
Now I can finally relax and sleep. Wait, huh? Yeah!
Oh my god, I don't know.
Hajime has gone limp. Please get a hold of yourself. He regained consciousness? Oh, I'm so glad. I thought you died from suffocation. Mikan, why are you here? The Monokuma announcement hasn't aired yet. Now that you mention it, I came here to wake you up, but it seems like I accidentally fell asleep. What kind of accident is that? But good news. You see, Nagino's condition has stabilized. Really? And I rushed over to let you guys know, but Ibuki's room is locked, so... Oh yeah, my lock is still broken. Thanks, Ibuki.
Yes!
Anyway, please hurry over. Nagito can probably be saved. Yeah, got it. I quickly got dressed and headed over to the hospital with Mika. Although I did wonder why it was necessary to be so pumped up for someone like Nagito. Oh well, best not to think about it. Alright. Let's go
back to the hospital. There
I saw Nagito. I managed to sit up in the bed. Nagito, can you hear me? Hajime came by to see how you were doing. The twin Ibukis are singing. I see. Ibuki must have been a twin duo. The Veronicas! What? Is he supposed to be cured?
Well...
It's not like he's completely cured. He was just able to recover from his critical condition. Realizing their characteristic as twins, and they've been taking turns appearing before me. Which means there are actually 17 people on this island.
What is he? Oh my Lord, have mercy.
Veronica, that's the answer. After seeing this, it might have been better if he stayed quiet for just a bit longer. I'm so glad. I'm so relieved Nagito regained consciousness. I'm so glad. I feel dizzy. Somehow, everything is spinning around me. Shouldn't you get some rest already? You should be exhausted from nursing down to sleep, right? If you insist, I'll use the on-call room upstairs. You must be mentally exhausted, so it's better if you relax in the lobby instead. Yeah, I'll do that. Even though it's morning, good night. Mikan wobbled around a bit, then left the room. She's definitely exhausted. Well, it's understandable. I mean, she fell asleep and she was supposed to come wake me up.
Man!
All alone with Hajime, huh? I can't stand being in the same room as you. Don't worry, I'm leaving. You should focus on curing that crappy disease of yours. Yeah, hurry up and go away. I don't want to see your face anymore.
What the heck is it?
Remember, he has the liar's disease.
Oh.
Alright, now we're gonna go check on the monitor because I accidentally skipped over that. Oh, hold on. Huh? The surveillance camera's unit's light is blinking. That's weird. It's not transmission time yet.
Oh,
let's
shit.
See what's going on.
Oh, shit.
If the light is blinking, they received some sort of transmission from the other side, right? That's pretty early. We haven't even received the Monokuma announcement yet. It might be something urgent, though. If so, there's no way I can make them wait until Fuyuhiko gets here. Alright, even if it's just me, I should receive the transmission. I reached my hand and pressed the reception button on the surveillance camera unit. Huh?
Oh.
That doesn't look good.
What the hell?
Upon first glance, I immediately knew it wasn't a normal video. A slow, swaying dim light is shining on the back curtain, black curtains. It felt like some sort of ritual was about to begin. Is this light from a candle? But what was creepiest of all was the rope hanging from the ceiling. The end of the rope was tied in a loop, and beneath it there was a stepladder. It was like a gallows. What is this? I didn't understand at all. What's going on at the music venue? And that's when it happened.
What?
The moment I saw a silhouette slowly entering the frame of saw a silhouette slowly entering the frame from the side of the screen. Chills ran down my spine, as if someone was dragging ice on me. A person wearing a hospital gown and a hemp bag on their head. What the? As I raised my voice in surprise, the person in the hospital gown slowly started moving. And began climbing the stepladder.
No way.
Slowly, slowly they took their time climbing it. They reached over to the rope hanging from the ceiling. Are you kidding me? And at that moment... Huh? The screen suddenly went pitch black, probably because the candle, the only source of light, had gone out. Hey! No matter what I said, there was no response from the darkness on the other end of the monitor. What the heck is this? What's going on?
Oh shit.
What in the world is going on? No, it doesn't matter. I have to do something about this. I might still be able to make it. I need to hurry over to the music venue. I rushed out of the hospital and ran over to the music venue where the transmission was made. Oh boy.
Damn, man.
Nico should be arriving here shortly. No, I don't have time to wait for it. I've got to get to the music venue. Oh, let's see what's going on. Oh, my pet. Okay, I can take a quick break in the tension. It's so cute, isn't it? Anyway. Cheating.
Oh man, here we go.
Please, please let me make it. I rushed to the music venue with a prayer in my heart. But I completely forgot. Prayer means nothing on this island.
Aw, shit.
Here it comes.
No! Ibuki!
I hate this so much.
That is not even cool.
I was too late. What the hell is this? In the hot air inside the music venue, I couldn't keep myself from shouting. Hot air. This is so hot. Why is this strange hot air inside the music venue? No, I don't have time to worry about that. More importantly, why isn't anyone coming? What is everyone doing? The body discovery announcement? That's right. The others now. I should hurry. I ran to the hotel as fast as I could, trying desperately not to trip over my own feet. That's all the shit's going down now. Hey, somebody get out here. As soon as I arrived at the motel, I started shouting for help as loud as I could.
You fiend!
I was wondering who was making such an infernal racket. So it was you. Gundam, something awful has happened.
What?
Don't tell me. Do you intend to spread the pathogenic bacteria so you can take us all down with you?
I won't let you!
I won't let you. If you want to pass, you must get to defeat me first. What happened? Is there a problem? Fighting is not allowed. It's worse than trouble. There's a body. Huh? Did you hear me? A body was found.
Could it be?
Body?
Yeah!
Yo!
What?
Hold on, I gotta call real quick.
Alright, yeah, sure.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna mute the mic. Alright, I'm back. Sorry about that.
That's alright, man.
Yeah. Alright, back to the Gucci stuff.
I renounce you!
Couldn't be. Seems like spread lies by Nagito and Gucci can fix this all.
Hold it.
Is that true? Of course it is. Isn't it obvious?
You see?
Yeah, we've seen Nagito's mission, yes. So you just have the same symptoms as him.
Come on, Gundam.
There's no way we should check it out. There's a much more time for truth.
That's...
killing?
Hey.
If that's true, check it out.
Fine.
If that is the case, I won't stop you.
Leave this to me!
Leave this place to me, and you fiends go on ahead.
Him and his fiends.
No need to worry. No need to worry. I will catch up with you easily. That sounds like... famous last words. Johnny, can you go?
Yep.
Yeah, it's better if we hurry, right? And off we go.
Chiaki.
Hajime!
Is that how you say it? Oh,
Econ, why are you here?
Yeah.
Help us.
Hey.
Hajime, someone's coming from over there.
Huh?
Hajime and Chiaki? What are you guys doing here? Yuhiko, why are you here too?
No shit!
Isn't it obvious? I'm looking for Ibuki. For Ibuki?
Oh.
I was pointing the rest of them in the call room. I wanted to check on everyone before I did that. And Ibuki's missing from the hospital all of a sudden. Huh?
Perhaps.
That's what Hajime was saying earlier. Everyone, let's hurry.
Huh?
Hurry where? To the music venue. Don't ask, just follow me.
Huh?
Damn it! My wound hasn't completely healed yet. Don't make me hurt too much.
Hey.
Is it good inside her? The only way to know is go inside. It's a hang body. Performance had just ended. The moment of silence just before the audience breaks out into thunderous applause. In a few moments after that silence, a scream surfaced.
No way!
Holy shit, right, dude?
No! Freaking way.
There wasn't just a hanged body. There's also another body. A suspended body belonging to Hyoko.
Holy...
two people dead.
That was it? That was chapter 3?
No, that was the daily life. This is deadly life now.
Oh, okay, thank God. Dude, I was like, I can't hang off on that cliffhanger.
A body has been discovered!
Now then, after a certain amount of time has passed, the class trial will begin!
The class trial. Here we go.
A body has been discovered! Now then, after a certain amount of time has passed, the class trial will begin!
Two body discovery announcements in a row. That means... a hemp body with a hemp bag on its head. The other is a bending body. Both of these bodies discovered at the same time. What is this?
What?
Yokoin, who the hell is that other one wearing the hemp bag?
Could it be?
Two victims? But when I was here earlier, I didn't see Hyoko's body. I only saw that hanged body over there. Not even 10 minutes passed. But still, why? What is this? Impossible, impossible, impossible.
Shut the hell up!
Shut up, idiot.
This is just...
For now, we should lower that person wearing the hemp bag to the ground. Leaving it like that, it's just too sad.
Yes!
Yes. What about preserving the scene of crime?
Damn it!
Who fucking cares about that? There's a control panel for the baton light on the stage. You can lower the body with that. That one. Hugo ran over to the window of the stage and pressed the button on the control panel. Starving beast and baton lighting slowly descended. When it descended enough for us to reach it, we all went together to lower the body. Now, let's take it off the hemp bag, okay? Even though I expected it, I still didn't want to confront that reality. Under the hemp bag, there was no denying that the face I saw belonged to Ibuki.
Damn it!
Damn it! It's all my fault. If only I did a better job watching over Ibuki. It's not your fault, Mikan. No matter how we feel, but when it falls in...
What's the matter?
Jeez, it feels like someone died in here or something.
Wow.
So you finally showed up, the root of all evil.
What the heck?
How dare you call your big brother the root of all evil? I even went to the trouble of bringing everyone for you.
Are you kidding me?
What the hell is going on here?
That is
Ibuki
impossible.
And Hyoko?
What?
So two people have been killed.
What?
Well there, that's not all. I've also summoned the others who were at the hospital. The others.
This is troubling.
Looks like another serious incident occurred while I was unaware.
Damn it!
I can't believe they did such a horrible thing. Nagato, Akane, are you okay?
Huh?
Huh? Of course. What do you mean, of course?
No way!
I'm talking about the despair disease. Jeez, you guys, that stuff is totally over now. Over? Yeah, because I got bored.
I'm gonna kill Monica Mo.
I don't know. For that silly reason. And now that you're telling a story, there's no need to keep that motive around anymore. Yeah, that despair disease is gone now. So you don't have to worry about it anymore.
I wonder who did this nonsense.
That's impossible! How can you spread a disease and cure it so easily?
Here!
Aw, who cares about the intricate details? What matters is that it's already been cured.
Yahoo!
So, let's get back to our main topic and proceed as usual.
It's the Monokuma File! See ya later!
I'll be waiting at the class trial. Do your best to investigate.
This cannot be!
We have to do this again.
Silence.
We have no choice. Like last time, if this means one of us killed these two.
Let me tell you this.
I cannot let this be. Why do we have to do this?
Damn it.
Thinking like that won't do anything. We have to do this.
Damn it!
If we don't do anything, we'll all be executed.
What do you
yearn for? Place in this world. But what about Nekomaru? What's going to happen to him? Is he not going to participate this time? Is that even allowed? Nekomaru.
That's weird.
Strange. Ryan. Huh. It's nothing for you to worry about.
Hey.
Are you okay?
Yep.
Unfortunately, it seems I have nothing to worry about.
This is bad.
Since you had the liar disease, your afterfest could be lies. Maybe.
Leave it to me!
Please leave Nekomaru to me. Everyone must focus on investigating, so I must do my very best.
Alrighty!
Alrighty, I will definitely bring back Nekomaru when everyone's trust. It seems we should leave Nekomaru to Monami. What about guarding this area? Do we still need it?
Damn it.
I'll stay. I still don't feel good yet. It's better if I stay here too, right? I should perform the autopsy again, right?
Damn right!
Then, I'll leave that to you. Get started, so we can end this nightmare for good. That's right, we need to end this. We need to finish this once and for all. I know there's no way we can believe that one of us did this. For those two's sake, we need to find the truth. And then, we need to end this nightmare once and for all.
Huh?
Alright, I'm gonna end the episode off here now. Next time on Let's Play DanganRonpa 2, we are going to investigate the deaths of Ibuki and Hyogo.
Hell yeah.
See you guys then. Bye.
See ya.